majority of them on the road yesterday and today recruiting. They'll all get back tonight, first thing tomorrow morning, and we'll get back starting practice on Wednesday. But anytime you get an open date, you got to concentrate on yourself. What can you get better as a football team? So we'll focus on that this week and continue to break down Cincinnati tape and keep going with them on Monday night. But most of the work this week will be focused on us getting better as a team.
How much did you miss having an open date last year?
I think you always miss open days. They talk about player safety and welfare. I think they're moving in that direction. Looks like starting next year, I know they got a proposal out there to have a 14-week season where everybody gets two open dates. To be honest with you, it is a good thing for player welfare because the kids get an opportunity to get a week off, catch a breath, and get healthy before moving to the next group of games. So now, that being said, it is kind of early because that was only week three, so we're about to go 9 straight weeks after this week.
Yurecek talked about how since the start of camp and reporting, it's now about the halfway point for you guys.
He must be listening because that's what I told him on Sunday. he's right. I mean, with camp starting early like it has, to be honest, when we get ready to play, we're right almost in our 9-week period, halfway through the season right now as far as weeks are concerned, because you come in early and about 9 weeks from now, and of course, 9 straight weeks finishing up. So it is about the halfway point as far as that goes. So, and then they have been practicing. So I think it comes at a good time. Number one, I think we can get Obi and Haynes and Naquan and get all those guys back. Should be healthy and ready to go for Cincinnati. So hopefully Cincinnati will be as healthy as we've been all year.
Alex Millett's come in for Jordan, and he was kind of wide-eyed at first against NC State going in the third play of the game, but it seemed like he really did a good job last week.
Not just Alex, but we've had Ulmer, Will Ulmer, and Tariq Adams, there's three freshmen, redshirt freshmen, have all played a lot of snaps. And it's a good and bad. Good news is they're all three freshmen. They're back for three more years. The bad news is they shouldn't be playing as freshmen. So I thought they've held their own for the most part, and they'll just continue to get better. But it's good to see those three kids, young guys, winning what like they have.
Especially given the struggles last year, these first three games, I know it's a small sample size, but it seems like they've got a lot more confidence going into the bye week than last year.
They should. Because, like I said, I think we've only given up 2 sacks in 3 games, which is maybe one of the top couple teams in our league as far as sacks given up. So that's a good thing.
Coach, can I ask you a kind of a different type of question here? I interviewed a couple of your players before you came up here who were from the Houston area in Florida that were impacted by the hurricanes that came through those areas. And it would seem to me that if I'm a football player and my family is, part of all of this, it would be hard for me to concentrate on the game. So my question is, did you have a talk or any of the coaches have a talk with any of these players, say, hey, how you doing? Can you be focused on the game?
Well, I don't think there's any question. We've had probably 30-plus players affected by the storms, not only in Houston, but more affected by in Florida because we have so many South Florida kids. So a lot of those guys, there's no question, a week ago with that storm, had a lot of issues going on. Tyree Brady being one of them. His family had to move from where they were, got hit right direct on into Georgia and some things. So, and not just our football team. There's teams all over the country that are affected, that's been affected by that. So, we talk to them, support them, all we can, and help them through things. But for the most part, I thought they did a great job of focusing on the game and the task at hand. And I think for the most part, it's worked out okay for all.
How difficult is it to concentrate on the game when you have all of this going on in your, with your families?
Well, I mean, there's no question. Your family comes first. I mean, that's the most important thing is your family. That being said, I mean, these kids, they make sure their families are fine. And we helped them make sure that was okay. And then when game time rolled around, they understood that they got a lot invested in this football team and this program. And it was time to go play. They played. And probably for the most part, actually went out playing that game, regardless of whether it was last week or the week before, probably helped those kids take their families and everything they were going through off their mind because they enjoyed playing the game.
Kind of therapeutic.
Probably.
Has anything surprised you so far, just 3 weeks in?
I like the team. I like where we are at this point. I think some of the moves we've made defensively, I think, has really helped us. I mean, moving me inside, become a lot more athletic inside, and also the play of Ty Tyler playing both inside and outside has helped us. Just with our depth in there, I think think the emergence of Couch, Dozier, and the Durant deal with Fox Backer, all three of those kids play extremely well. And they all have a role, and you know, the linebackers, Ortiz is, anytime you get a junior college guy and you're not quite sure, but he's played tremendous. So, I mean, there's been a lot of guys. Steph Marcel Williams offensively is another guy that's a new guy that's just been tremendous for us. And so, I like where we have Tyler King. I was anxious to see how he came in there in the second half. Probably should have got him in the first half, but that's what I saw there. But he's, anytime you get a guy that hadn't played, you're concerned about being a freshman. He went ahead and played well, and that was great to see. So, I like where we are at this point. There's no question we have to get better as a football team, but I think I like what this team's all about. I like how hard they play. Right now we're a solid team that needs to continue to get better.
Tyler doesn't even talk like a freshman. He seems like a kid that kind of has got it figured out.
But he's kind of been that way since he's been here. You get a lot of these guys that come in, and he kind of took over that group of futures that were in there with Yuli and all those guys. And he was a leader of that group for the entire year, and that's a tight group. And carried over into the locker room at halftime there. He stood up and did some things I haven't seen a freshman do since. Compared to a couple of freshmen I have in NC State and Florida, but that being said, he stepped up and did some really good things. That was good to see.
And he just kind of proved that your offensive line was a couple of small things here and there in the first couple of games away from breaking some big.
Well, there's no question that if you get it back in, you get a great back. There's a lot of things can happen. That offensive line also gets a lot better. We've seen that over the years we've had here with Brad Shaw and all the guys that have come through this place. And same way anywhere. Anytime you've got a running back that's a tremendous back, some running backs, whatever you block, it's what they get. Other ones, whatever you block, they find a way to get more. He seems like he's that kind of guy, so it would have to be. But it was exciting to see what he went in there and did. He's a young guy that again, as a freshman, has to get better.
You mentioned that leadership aspect too, and it seemed like we were able to see a little bit of that on Saturday. The offense was struggling, and it seemed like every time the offense came off the field, the defensive guys made sure to sort of dap them up and make sure that they kept their head up and kept focused on the game. And last year it seemed a little bit more segmented, and now it's one unit.
I mean, this year, that's what good teams do. You got good teams, you got good, hold each other accountable, and that's what this team's done to this point. You've got to continue to do that. But I don't think, offensively, defensively, there's just a lot of examples of things out there that you pointed out to me on Sunday that was just. There's a reason we got a chance to be good. The way Keon Davis reacted to Tyler King being really successful was tremendous. Brady there, we get in that 4-minute drive with Brady, who likes catching balls, gets in there, tells that offensive line, we're not throwing, we'll find a way to get, not give the ball back. Just little things like that I notice in the head coach that tells me that we have a chance. We hang together, keep working hard to be a good football team.
You're talking about leaders who, talking about Tyler, Marcel and Ortiz, who have basically just gotten here. Of course, Ortiz and Marcel were in for spring, but early leadership.
Yeah. I've always thought Doug all along, probably two best leaders I've ever seen coaching, Tim Tebow as a freshman and Phillip Rivers as a freshman. Those guys are totally different, but those guys, I don't think you have to be a senior to lead. I think he's got to be a leader. You got to be a guy that sets standards and brings everybody up around him, and that's what those guys did. We got some guys. If you guys have had the opportunity to meet and get to know Ortiz Johnson and Marcel Williams, they're two of the best kids that have ever been around. And it's easy to see the way they go to work every day and the way they go about their business and practice and all that. They got the respect of their teammates, and it carries over to game day. You watch those guys go play, they play just like they prepare. The biggest thing about a leader is you get your respect to your teammates, but you can't just lead out here on this football field. You walk out the doors and go out on after practice and go to class and all those things you have to do. Those guys just do everything right. That's what leaders do, and those two guys are some great examples of what they should be.
Especially with Ortiz and Marcel being JUCO guys. You get limited time to talk to those guys, especially on the JUCO circuit. How as a coaching staff are you able to evaluate that type of leadership when you go into those JUCO situations?
Well, you just get a chance to know the kids, Marcel probably should not have been in junior college to begin with. Heavily wanted out of high school, but Todd Goble did a great job of recruiting Marcel and knowing exactly what we were getting into. You get a chance to sit down with him on your visits and all that. And of course, Adam Fuller did a great job of getting to know Ortiz. And some of the stories you had about Ortiz, what he did, in the junior college, were just he was just a kid there, just like he is here. I mean, he just helped people out. And what he did in the community and all that. So we knew what we were getting pretty much with both of them as people. You know, sometimes those junior college guys, and you guys, the Arnold Blackmans of the world, Taj Lettmans, all those guys we've had, it seems like you say after that first year, gosh, I wish I'd redshirted him because now you got him for two more years to become players. Well, these guys have really played the kind of beyond our expectations as first year JUCO kids, because normally you don't see guys come in like they have and play at the level they played being first year players, which was, they were both here in the spring, which helps. You know, they were here for the spring and summer and all that, which has helped. They're ahead of time than what most JUCOs are at this point.
You've been a coach a really long time. How, given the difficulties, especially in the interior, the front seven last year, and stopping the run and getting stops when you needed, have you ever seen such a big turnaround in your coaching career in run defense?
I mean, I don't want to. I mean, I think we're getting closer. You know, to be honest with you, no. I mean, I think we've made the moves we had to make, you know, to you know, move people, get the best people on the field. But just the development of players, a lot of that again goes to the strength room and Luke, and what's happened starting January is, as far as developing players, I mean, a lot of those players are the same players we had a year ago. They're just a lot better players right now because of their development. I mean, Ty Tyler's an example. Ryan B's gotten better, Blake Keller. You know, but the emergence of Durant, Couch, and Dozier, three guys were in the program a year ago, to be honest with you, didn't do anything. All, none, the three of them, they didn't contribute whatsoever. So you see those guys grow up and continue to develop as part of the program, which is what you should do with the program, is develop players. And then Chase Hancock's become a much better player. I mean, he's playing tremendous right now. And Mari Cobb's 30 pounds heavier. You know, those secondary guys are all a year older. And so you just see those guys start to develop as players because they're more mature and they're older. And then the pieces that we brought in that are the new pieces seem to fit really well. So.
Yeah. Another guy who's made a big step, I think, is Chris Jackson. He, you know, he had some moments last year you'd expect a true freshman to have at corner, and now look at him.
Yeah, he's amazing. Number one, he's a tremendous kid, you know, just like Artisa's guys were talking about. He's gained 20, 30 pounds. He's stronger. He's got a year under his belt. He's playing with a lot of confidence. Of course, you saw that happen with him, you know, throughout the year. A year ago, he got better, but he's carried over this year. He's a good young player, just a sophomore. He's good.
It seems like whenever Marshall was, you know, whenever you all were really successful 2 or 3 years ago, it was the offense that was propelling things. Do you think it takes fans a little bit to get used to, hey, you know, this is a defensive-led bunch?
Well, I think, Grant, if you look at us 3 years prior to last year, we were number one in conference total defense. You know, and offensively, we were good too. But the last, you know, the year before last, we won 10 games. We weren't great offensively, but we were number one in the conference in total defense, and we were number one in the country in special team efficiency. So we were really good on special teams, played tremendous defense, and took care of the ball. I mean, you could do all three. It's like the year before you go in a championship. That's what you do. You get all three pieces click in offense, defense, and special teams. Three of the last 4 years, we've had at least those other 2 years, we probably have both of them clicking pretty good. The third year, we were better on defense and special teams. Offensively, had to come around. We had a true freshman quarterback, but we won 10 because we did the other two. And this year, we just got to continue to get better in all three phases. But I'm not saying we're at that point yet, but you know, I think defensively, we've got a chance to keep getting better to be that team. And offensively, we've got the pieces in place. We just have to improve and keep getting better. We're special teams. We've done some good things. We're going to keep getting better too.
You feel like points have too much value with fans and everybody in today's college football landscape?
Just win. Just win is hard. I mean, my goodness. I mean, it's so hard to, you look around the country right now. And, I mean, Nebraska would like to have a 1-point win right now. I promise you that. You know, there's a lot of teams out there that, you just the important thing is you walk out of here with the win, and that's all that matters. So, you like to score 50 every time? Sure. But at the end of the day, I mean, our goal right now is just to come out at 1 point better than the team we play, go back, get ready again for next week, and try to improve the team. So, I think, Keith probably still a guy that likes his great defensive performances. I mean, how many of you get a shutout? I mean, a lot of people used to walk out here really happy with that defense. So, anyway, at the end of the day, I think all that matters is just winning the game.
Early read on Cincinnati, you got to see them play Miami.
I think there's no question they got a lot of athletes, they got a lot of players. That was a good game, and I would get the opportunity to see it. Came down right to the end there, and I guess Miami threw a pick six and lost the game right at the end. But I guess that was an excellent game. Of course, they got Navy this week, which will do us a lot of good because of what Navy does offensively. Defensively, it'll help us a little bit. But like I said, we'll focus on us this week. It'll be a great challenge going to Cincinnati and playing. Of course, I guess we're going to play another night game, so it's around the hoop. It'll be great. Number one, it's a great game because if our fans can get there, you know, we can all drive there and show up. And